What's the name of the company?
Moab Cowboy.
Moab Cowboy.
Wow.
Yep.
We're going to be cowboying.
I have to look it up online.
Oh, voiceover.
Yeah, voiceover. Yeah, we're just going to go up and run this algebra bank with them and get an idea of what it's like. I don't know that we'll bring the Bronco, but this is just another aspect of this adventure. Talk to you later.
So the phone number is 435-220-0746. Moab Cowboy. Awesome. So these guys, Mark and Bill, I believe, from back east, trailered their razors, and they followed us in for a small fee that let you follow them in. It's pretty cool.
Creepers.
All right, Dave's showing us some dinosaur tracks, and then we kept on going after we saw all these dinosaur tracks, and then he shows us lion's back. There it is. Oh my gosh.
Down by the bushes, there's a divot taken out.
Yes.
About 10 feet to the left of that, there's approximately a 50-foot tall black cross.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's just Mother Nature. Nobody painted it. So on a map, this is called Abyss Canyon. So one of the interesting things about Moab is they name all the big rocks. So way off in the distance, it's called Moab Bronco. And all those big ones out there are named. But they do that for search and rescue. They average about 6 trips a day out to recover people.
6?
It's usually hikers, bikers.
Lost?
Lost, dehydrated, broken arm, broken.
They're constantly doing this every day?
All day, every day, yeah. We have base jumpers that get hurt a lot. We have rock climbers that get hurt a lot. So they're constantly out watching those guys. So they average about 6 a day. And it's hardly ever side by side. The rock climbers and post jumpers for bicycles. And it goes to the river and back, and you have to be in really good shape, a lot of water to make it. unless you have a motor.
You're not getting in, just so you know.
The gas. Yeah.
But there's a few different ways out of here.
Now, how many degrees is that, Dave?
I don't know. At least I didn't measure that before because it wasn't steep enough.
Oh.
I
like it.
45.
Yep.
Crazy.
And I'm going to show you an 83. We're not going to do it, but I'll show you an 83 along the way.
83 degree incline?
Yeah.
That's almost straight up.
Or decline if you go down it, I guess.
Yeah.
Just a little faster that way.
Yeah, go real fast. That'll help.
Yeah.
But, get harder.
This is unreal.
The next part of our trip is pretty easy. It's mostly sandy. We'll get a little bit faster. A couple of little rocks, nothing serious. Nothing like we just did.
What we just did was really
cool. Yeah,
we go back out there.
I feel like you're addicted.
No, we go back out there.
You love
them.
I know. You're like, I found your ticket.
I love saying that to me. Fly from the team.
Yeah.
This is America's question.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, dear.
Jeepers, creepers. Look at all these jeeps.
You need to bring the Bronco up here.
Yeah, your Bronco.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So I've seen Broncos go down this other side over here in the steep part.
Mm-hmm.
Jeep party.
That guy didn't even air down, though.
No, it has a kid.
Post air down.
Well, if these rigs, they should be aired down.
Most guys have done like 20 pounds out here. Like
yeah. Unless you get in the sand.
I never even thought about it.
No.
We run like 12, 15 pounds of cars. He went over the first hill and we'll drive out here.
It's supposed to be a little gear.
Yeah, your belt is stretching.
Okay, well, better go a little
gear. Yeah, that's the only thing about the belt.
Yeah, I've been watching.
We'll get out of these jeepers' way, okay? Let them park.
There she is. Hell's Gate, Moab, Utah. We have arrived. Unbelievable. It's everything that I see dirt everyday guys do. Only they're not here to show me their carnage. But it's definitely everything that they show you on TV and more when you're here personally looking at it. It's intimidating. That's crazy stuff. Crazy stuff. We'll get back with you later.
Are you going?
I got open dips. I can't do this. I win.
I think I'm the same way.
Okay, here we go. We've got some Jeeps. Gonna come up Hell's Gate. Entertain us a bit. So I think I might get up in case they're coming right where we're sitting.
Your jeeps here from the East Coast?
part one, part two, and part three of a Moab. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching Scott's Montana Adventures. See y'all later.